Greetings, this is another video overview by the flashlight reviewer Selfbuilt. Today I'm looking at the MMR X from Foursevens. This is part of the Maelstrom line, or their tactical line of lights. It's a distinctive light because it has a built-in 18650 rechargeable battery that can be recharged inside the light. So I've tested a number of these lately. You'll see how the Foursevens version compares. As usual, you have the new kind of modern packaging, display-style packaging with the the light clearly shown in the bottom part. Specs are shown along the top. Let me just open it up here and take you through the light and the features. And I might as well start by taking out the full kit, because I'll need some of the parts in here to show you how everything works. So the light, first off, is fairly compact for an 18650 light. There's typical bands of knurling here in the head and the body and the tail. Not overly aggressive, but better than most lights, so I think you'll find the overall grip is actually fairly decent given the small size. You can see a number of features. There's a protruding forward tail cap, so you can see it protrudes. Clicky switch. There is an LED indicator letting you know the charge status of the light. And there's a USB port, but it's hidden underneath this ring. So if you start to unscrew, you'll see there are some screw threads. The ring opens up, and you can actually slide it over part of its length. There's obviously an O-ring in there for water resistance, because it's actually quite stiff compared to a lot of other ones that I've tested. You just need to unscrew it a few times to get it started. You can see there's a micro USB slot right there in the light, where you'll plug in to charge the battery as well as to reprogram its states. And I'll go through all that in a moment. You can see it uses an XM-L2 emitter. There it is at the base of a reasonably deep and smooth reflector. So you should get reasonably good throw for the size, although it won't be a heavy thrower, of course, given the overall size of the light. There's a stainless steel crenellated bezel, so you can tell if the light is on when it's upside down, plus more impact resistance if you want that. So the package that comes with the light is fairly extensive. You'll get the usual kind of Maelstrom manual that'll walk you through the feature set. It's a little bit more detailed maybe than most, because it has a few more options in how you can program the light, which I'll go through in a moment. Here's the USB charging cable. So you get sort of a standard USB connector, a standard USB plug on one end, a micro USB plug on the other. You have an AC adapter that you can just plug into with an indicator as well to let you know when it's charging. You have the usual 4.7s type belt holster, so fairly decent quality. Again, the usual fairly high quality wrist lanyard as well. You also get the extra, in this case, kind of a nice feature. They give you an extra switch with the light and an extra boot cover. You also get extra O-rings in there as well. And there's an optional black flat bezel cover if you don't want the stainless steel. So not a bad package, all said and done. More options than you would typically see. Let me just sort of start by showing you how the charging feature works. So I'm just going to bring up here, plug that in. You'll see the charging light comes on red when it's not connected. And what we'll do is we'll just plug this right into the head of the light. And you'll see what happens. So I've got a battery in there, and I'll show you the battery in a moment. The red here indicates that the battery is now charging. It's not fully charged, sitting inside the light. You can still see as well the light is on there on the charging brick adapter. It's important to note that you can only reprogram the modes of the light when you're charging it. So it's kind of an unusual feature. You need to have the 4.7s battery in there, and you need to have it plugged in to reprogram the light. And I'll show you all that in a minute. Let me just show you the default configuration. And for that, let me just show you as well what the battery looks like. You have what looks like a traditional tail cap, although there's actually a plastic disc in there I'll get to in a moment. There are square-cut threads, but they are not anodized for lockout, and that's fairly common for lights that have a built-in charger. It needs to be a constant current path, even when the light is clicked off. The 18650 battery is a bit unique. You can see on the positive terminal there are two regions. There's actually the positive contact in the center and a negative contact on the outside. This is how charging occurs, as well as the negative contact in the base. If you look inside the light, it's a little hard to see. Let me get you a little bit more light in there. Maybe I'll just turn that down a little for you. So at the head of the light, there are two springs that you can see there, the inner spring and the outer spring. And this is how charging occurs across that battery. As you can tell, you need to use the custom 18650 from 4.7s to charge inside the light or to reprogram the light. Again, you can only reprogram the light when it's charging, and that means this battery has to be inside in order for you to reprogram the light. So you can see the two contacts. Foursevens recommends if you want to use your own 18650, you can, but because of the risk of shorting across those two springs in the head, they recommend you take out this plastic disc in the tail cap and instead mount it in the head. So in essence, just to block out the outer spring, it'll prevent you from accidentally trying to charge or short a standard 18650. It's a thoughtful design if you want to use your own batteries, but frankly, you're best off sticking with the custom 18650 because this is what you're going to need for the full set of programmability and usability of the light. So, an interesting setup. So again, now how does the light work? In its default configuration, it comes in and preset into a two-mode state. Click the forward clicky switch to turn on the light. In this case, you see it in low. Click it off and back on rapidly to get the next mode, which is high. So it's just a two-stage light in its default configuration, low and high. You don't have to click. It's a momentary forward clicky, so you can just partially press, release, partially press, and so on to switch between the two modes. Then you'll click for locked on. So very straightforward. The programming part is interesting, so let me take you back in here and plug that back on. So again, you can see the red light comes on. I think that goes green when it's fully charged. So now the light is charging, you can reprogram it. To reprogram it, there are five possible modes. And this is described in the manual. Get that to focus for you a little bit. You can see there are five configurations. The default is configuration 2, which is max and low mode. But you can have a strobe mode, you can have max only. You can also have all the way up to the configuration 5, which is moonlight, low, high, max, SOS, strobe, and two beacon modes. And they all work the same way. You just cycle through by pressing the switch. So to show you how to change that, what you do is when it's plugged in, you press the switch on. Now rather than come on, the light is flashing the indicator status for which of those five modes. So two flashes means it's in mode 2, which is high-low. If you click off and back on at a normal sort of pace, you see it's advanced and flashing 3 times. So that's the 3-mode option. Click it off and back on again 4 times for the 4-mode option. Off and back on again up to 5 times now. Maybe I'll leave it at this one because it gives you the full set. You'll see it just keeps reflashing 5. After 10 seconds, it will memorize that this is the configuration that you want, and it'll exit from the menu. And you'll see that in a moment. So the only point to this is that you have to kind of memorize what the five modes are or have the manual if you want to change on the fly. I suspect most people will just change this once and then use it in whatever format that they've set it to. There we go. So you see it set itself. What it does after it sets itself is it turns itself on in the lowest mode of the new set, or the default first mode, which in this case was a moonlight level. So I'll just turn it off, and it continues charging. But it's now set as the level 5 configuration, which has the most output modes. And I'll just show you what those look like. So in this configuration, when you turn it on, you get moonlight, which is a very low moonlight level. And you'll see numbers in my review for the estimated lumen output. And then you cycle. Sort of a low, high, turbo. Then you get into the blinking modes. There's your SOS mode. There's your nice fast tactical strobe mode. There's one of your blinking beacon modes. And then there's the next one. And back again to moonlight. So those are your various levels. The light has mode memory, so if you turn it off in a certain level, let it sit for a little bit. When you turn it back on, you're back in the level you left it. And if you just click off and back on more quickly, you start over the ramp. And you notice what it did here. It starts over the ramp at the lowest level of the sequence. Something like a ramp, I should say. The sequence of output mode. So if I turn it off, let's say, let it memorize in the high mode for a second. Turn it back on, I'm in high. If I click to advance, it starts at the very first position, which was moonlight. So it's something to keep in mind. That may look complicated, but you know, it doesn't have to be. If you want, you can just, for example, just plug it back in here. You could turn it back off and back on. Sorry, there we go. I've been moving it up a couple, but let's move it back down to one. Let's see, one flash. Okay, so one flash. This is the simplest way you can run the light. Just turn it off, unplug it. Now the way it works is as a single mode high only. So every time you press the switch, all you get is single high. So you know that's an option for you as well. It's very customizable, you have a lot of choices. Once you have set the mode that you want and you're done charging, I recommend you just sort of screw that closed again. Maximum waterproofness, of course, will be when that's fully tight. I don't know if they've ported the plug. A lot of manufacturers do, but I wouldn't want to take a chance. I recommend you keep that closed when not in use. And it should be pretty good and pretty waterproof. A few other build items I forgot to mention as well. There's a lanyard attachment point here in the tail cap, as well as another deeper groove on this side. So you have a couple of options to how you want to attach things in addition to the holster. I guess for the final comments, just for the overall beam pattern, you can see it's not bad. The lighting here in my office, as always, plays tricks with you for tint. But you can see it's a fairly traditional looking beam. You got sort of a decent width overall spill beam, a fairly focused hotspot. There's a bit of a corona around the hotspot. It's not a very sharp demarcation, as you'd expect given the small head. So if we go out a little bit, you can see there's kind of a nice even sort of hotspot. And you know, a pretty good beam pattern overall. Pretty much what you'd expect for a light of this size. The max output is not as high as some other recent lights I've tested. It's not bad. But again, you'll see, you know, it's certainly more than enough light for any given task. But it's not going to be the ultimate barn, retina scorcher light. Very bright for the size, but there are brighter ones out there if you're looking for that type of feature. It's really more for the balanced sort of light, a balanced sort of beam, and the rechargeable option built right in. So to learn more about the light, including how its performance, output measures, and runtimes, see my full review at Candle Power Forums. You'll find me in the flashlight review forum under the username selfbuilt or my personal website, flashlightreviews.ca. Thanks for your time. Hope you found that useful.